a bull guard on a 2015 Jeep Patriot. The car belongs to my father-in-law, and he just decided he wanted to put this on there, so I'm going to tackle that. Hopefully it's just a couple bolts. I haven't really messed with it. You know, I'm going to bring the car into the garage today. I'm going to put it on some ramps. I can, you know, get underneath the front to see. From what I've seen right now, it's just a couple of, there's plastic pieces down there that need to be removed in order for me to be able to find out, I guess, where the points are that it's going to bolt. So I'm going to be unwrapping. I ordered the bull guard. I can't remember how much it was. I'll probably put it in the description and talk about it later. But I ordered it off of eBay, and it's all wrapped up. So this is what it looks like from the packaging that it came in. And it just says bull guard with skid plate, 2.5 inch. So I'm gonna open this up and kind of take a look to see where, you know, how this is gonna fit on the front of a Jeep Patriot. Having an issue trying to get this. I had taken that apart previously, and I've kind of put it back together because I was planning to, you know, come back to it. But this bracket—it's not a bracket; it's actually a bolt that goes into a hole. This whole piece does, so that you can, you know, secure, you know, this large tubular bracket that holds the bull guard. And this has to go into a hole on the back side of the frame there, the metal frame, so that the bolt can go through here. Problem is, there's an imperfection from the factory, so that even I have three of these. Two of them go in perfectly fine. This one hole is the bracket's not. I mean, the hole, there's a little piece of metal that's protruding. Now it's hard for me to get in there to try to cut the metal. So what I'm going to do is try to take the very top. It's just touching. So I'm just taking a Dremel tool, and I'm just going to, you know, take the top off of it. It shouldn't really mess with it structurally. I don't see it having an issue, because it still has got a lot to grab onto. So I'm going to be cutting that out, and hopefully that'll let me slide that in so that I can put this bracket on. And eventually I'm going to also be cutting the holes for where the brackets are going to protrude through. So I'll be doing that after I finish with this, but this should hopefully solve that issue. Now, I thought about cutting the metal in the car, but it's pretty difficult to get to without taking that whole plastic piece out, and that goes all the way up. I just don't want to mess with it. I'd rather just go ahead and cut the bolt down a little bit, and that should solve my issue. Thank you. Go in. There's a slot up there. These go in there so that you can bolt that into there. So there's a couple of spots. There's one in there. And there's one here in the center. Off to the side. Those go right in there. Alright. And from there, these are spacers that go, you know, there. This goes up in this orientation. And then the bolts go, actually the spacers go on top. And the bolts kind of go through. That's what I'm shooting for here. Bracket in there. Everything else fits nicely. That's what it looks like. Now it's just a matter of putting these brackets on. What everything kind of looks like, and you know, the bullhorn attaches to that. You have one of the brackets up there, where it attaches to. You got a bolt, and then you know, you have to cut this hole out in order to get, so this can kind of come through. There's one in the middle. Oh, actually, the one in the middle is underneath there, you can't really see it. You have to go in through there, and then you have that one there. So that's the basic setup. And I'm all done. It's not that difficult, as you know. I just had to modify, you know, that piece to fit into here up top. So that's what I had to modify. Other than that, now I just gotta tighten, you know, adjust these so that I can, you know. I guess it'll sit where it needs to. So I'm gonna do that and adjust these, tighten these down once I have it in place, in a place that I want it, and that should be it. And that's your finished product.